Try to put yourself into the mindset of being a patient. And now imagine that you're sitting in your doctor's office and your doctor tells you that your blood pressure is too high. And that even though you've been exercising and you changed your diet and you lost weight, your blood pressure has remained too high and now it's time for medication. So raise your hand if you want to be proactive. You want to aim for perfect blood pressure control and you'll do whatever it takes to get that. Okay. Now raise your hand if you feel that your blood pressure doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. You want the minimum amount of medication. Okay, so the first mindset, we call that the maximalist. You want to be ahead of the curve, do everything and more. And the second group, that's the minimalist, less is more.
So your doctor prescribes a blood pressure medication. And it turns out that the medication comes in two forms. One is extracted from an herb, from a natural source. The other is synthesized in a laboratory using the latest technology. Both are chemically identical, and both cost the same. The doctor offers you a choice. Raise your hand if you would prefer a medication that comes from a natural source. Okay? And raise your hand if you would prefer a medication that's synthesized in a laboratory using technology. Okay. So the first group, which actually represents about 60% of the United States in broad surveys, has what we call a naturalism orientation. That when someone has a medical condition or problem, he or she prefers or looks to a natural solution, whether it be herbal, acupuncture, massage, meditation, something that may be amenable, in his or her opinion, to the issue. The second group has what we call a technology orientation. These are people who look to the lab and often are looking to the latest, greatest high-tech treatment or breakthrough.
So finally, your doctor gives you a prescription for the medication that you chose, and you fill the prescription. And now you're sitting down, you're about to take your first pill. So raise your hand if you swallow it down, confident that you're on the right path to solving your problem of high blood pressure. Now raise your hand if you take the pill out of the bottle, stare at it for a little while, then read the package insert a few times about all the possible side effects, and then wonder if you should really take it. So the first group, we term the believers. Believers are certain that there's a good solution for their problem, whatever that solution might be. Once they find it, they're ready to go ahead. The doubters, that's the second group, worry that the treatment will be worse than the disease. So the terms for these mindsets came out of the many interviews that we did with patients. These were the common threads that reflected their approach to their health and to medical problems. And these mindsets applied not only to issues like high blood pressure or high cholesterol, but also to decisions around surgery and treatment of cancer. Now, it's not just patients who have these mindsets. As you can see in this audience, doctors and other medical professionals have them too. So now we want to get a little personal and talk about our own medical mindsets. So Jerry, you go first.
Okay. So I was raised in a family with a very strong Eastern European Jewish tradition where doctors were on a pedestal. Physicians like Jonas Salk and Albert Sabin were heroes for their work with polio. Science and technology were greatly honored as well,